Natural language, the way people usually talk and write, has an extensive range, meaning that there are many ways to say the same thing. For instance, soda, pop, soda pop, coke, soft drink, and carbonated beverage are all words that can be used to describe the same concept. This natural range can make it confusing when searching a library database for articles. For example, let's say you are using a database to find information on the topic of the Civil War. What term would you use to search? Civil War? Civil wars have taken place all over the world. So do you use American Civil War, U.S. Civil War, War Between the States, The Lost Cause, War of Secession? The choices seem almost endless. Does this mean you have to try and think of every possible term to describe the Civil War? Not if you use a database's controlled vocabulary. A controlled vocabulary gathers all materials available on a topic under one word or phrase, thus taking a lot of time and guesswork out of searching. A controlled vocabulary is not going to be called controlled vocabulary in the database. Databases may use the terms thesaurus, subject terms, subject headings, descriptors, or another specialized name depending on what database you are using. To demonstrate how to use a database's controlled vocabulary, I'll use Academic Search Complete and start out by doing a pretty broad search for war in movies. I'll click on the title of an article to view the summary page and find a list of hyperlinked subject terms, which are part of the controlled vocabulary in Academic Search Complete. The list of subject terms gives me an idea about the content of the article, which also gives me a fast and easy way to determine if the article will be useful. Notice how movies is not listed as a subject term, but the word motion pictures is. There are also some pretty specific subject terms here as well, such as violence in motion pictures and war films. Clicking on one of these hyperlinked terms will start a new search, which will likely lead me to fewer but more useful results for my topic. You can also use the controlled vocabulary before starting a search by using the subject terms link at the top of the page. Remember, in other databases, you may find alternative names for this, such as thesaurus or subject headings. So in this case, I'll click the subject terms link, enter the word movies into the box, and then hit the browse button. Since movies is not listed as a subject term, the database suggests using the term motion pictures. Clicking on the hyperlink for motion pictures is going to show me more information. The scope note provides a brief definition of the word. Usually, broader, narrower, and related terms are listed under the scope note. Any one of these terms can be checked off and added to the search. I'm going to check the box next to motion pictures and add it, and you'll see that it now appears in the search box. Now I can do the same thing for the word war, except after checking the box next to war, I'm going to select the connecting term and to tell the database that I want to find articles covering both of these subjects. Now when I run the search, I have fewer results than in my original keyword search that are much more on target with what I'm looking for. And when I click on the title of one of my results, the two subject terms that I used in my search are found on the list. Here are a few final tips for using controlled vocabulary in your searches. Start with your own keywords, and don't abandon doing keyword searches. It is best to use a variety of techniques when looking for information in order to find out what works the best. Browse a database's subject terms or thesaurus in order to find preferred terms and related, narrower, or broader terms. Finally, certain fields like medicine, education, and business use very specific terminology. Always check the controlled vocabulary when searching databases related to those fields in order to discover specific terminology used in them.